Morning, everyone.
Morning, everybody.
Webinar proper. I'd like to play a song for you. It's actually called A One Moment in Time, originally sang by Whitney Houston, and was produced as an inspirational song for the 1988 Summer Olympics, Seoul, South Korea. An anthem for believing in yourself against all odds. As the lyric goes, each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. We have Dana Wiener singing One Moment in Time. Enjoy, friends.
Each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I faced the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this much remains. I want one moment in time when I'm more than I thought I could be, when all I've lived to be the very best, and I want it all, no time for less. I've laid my plans, now lay the chance here in my hands. Give me one moment in time when I'm more. Then in that one
Wow, powerful song, right, everyone? Okay, let's start the webinar proper. Today, we celebrate our Get Employed Today's Cohort 1 participants as they made a decision to take action to participate in Get Employed Today's program to be a job ready and ready to earn. Welcome, Team LTT Global, and welcome to our Get Employed Today's Cohort 1 participants. Let's invite Mr. Suresh, our Global Partnership Officer, to say a few words. Over to you, Suresh.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Colin. Welcome, everyone, to all participants. What I would like to very simply be able to say is that in LTT Global, we thoroughly believe in lifelong learning. Upskilling is not just right now. It should be actually happening every day, every week, every month. And that is what we thoroughly in the team believes in. And why the problem in the country or in the world today is basically because a very small number understands the importance of upskilling. And thereon, that very few people are the ones who are truly, whether it's the pandemic or financial crisis, those who believe in upskilling are the ones who will be excelling. Because when situations change, before pandemic, after pandemic, before financial crisis, after financial crisis, those who believe in upskilling and lifelong learning, they are always prepared. Bottom line, they'll always have this belief that change is constant. Yeah, you all would have always heard this term, change is constant. So whether with whatever access you have, and you constantly upskill. Upskill doesn't mean you must get into a course every day. Yeah? Upskill could mean that you always keep your ears to the ground. You hear about current happenings in the world. You read a lot. You go to different sites about current happenings, technology, non-technology, what happened away from maybe. You could be coming from the area of human resource, or you could be from engineering, but you could read so many different areas because it's important to know about everything. Everything is interrelated in this world today. 10 years, maybe 20 years ago, changes happens once a year. 10 years ago, maybe changes happens 9 months. 5 years ago, changes started happening every 6 months. Right now, changes happens maybe even every month. That's how you can see technology, right? Technology drives all the changes that we are going through. So whether we say that the technology is not relevant to me or not relevant or whatnot, it is, we are all connected. You can simply see in the handphones. You buy a handphone, every now and then there's an update. What that update means is that they're increasing the features in the phone with the update to the software. Or to whatever the update they make, a small update to overall. That says all about how frequently technology is changing. And that also informs us on how important it is when it comes to upskilling, whether you take the course or constantly read. Yeah, so that is my message today to all of you. during this program, within the mandatory courses and everything else that's available within the platform, it's a huge platform with more than 1 billion curated global content. So grab this opportunity, learn everything you can during these 2 to 6 weeks. Thereon also, when you have access, fully go in every day and learn everything you can. Be the champion. The platform is there to make you a champion. Become the champion. Yeah, you got the platform. Use it and become the champion. Back to you, Colin. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Suresh. Now, let us hear from Inje Analis, our digital learning consultant.
Okay, thank you, Colin. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the program. And I just would just like to add to what Suresh has mentioned. I guess from the list of participants, you all are quite diverse group. There are people in their 20s, some in their 30s, 40s, and so on. And you have had experience in so many different industries, from banking to sales and marketing to all kinds of other industries. I guess what I would like to highlight to all of you is that this pandemic has hit us very hard. A lot of people have lost their jobs. A lot of businesses have had to close down. And it affects a lot of people, young people who are graduates, who are just out from university or college and trying to get a job. But I just want to assure you that this is not the first crisis that we have gone through. Yeah, Malaysia and the rest of the world have had many, many crises. Personally, I've been involved in, I think, three different crises in the last 30 years or even 40 years. In the late 80s, when I was just starting my career, I was involved. I was also hit by the crisis in the economic downturn at that time. Malaysia was hit hard. In the late 90s or early 2000s, there was another crisis. A lot of people lost their jobs. A lot of businesses closed down. But yet, today, we are still here. The country is still standing. The society, the community is still there. Yeah. So I just want to let you all know that what you are going through now is not the end of the world. And in fact, I would even say it's like a cycle. Maybe 10, 12 years from now, you will go through another cycle of crisis, of pandemic, and then you will be able to say, oh, I've survived the last one, I can survive through this one. Yeah. So don't think that it is the end of the world. All of you, the young ones especially, still have got a long way to go. So take this opportunity to upskill yourself, to be prepared, to be ready to encounter any other hardships that may come during your future careers. Yeah. In Malaysia, there has been a lot of effort by the government, by ministries like Ministry of Higher Education, the Ministry of Entrepreneurship and Economic and Cooperative Development. Even state governments like Selangor also have different programs. They are running all kinds of programs to help the unemployed to provide employment. Yeah? This program, GetEmployed.today, is the only private initiative offered by a company. So you all are quite lucky because, as you know, the government agencies, ministry, they all have got their programs, but sometimes it's not easy to get into those programs. Yeah, this program through LTT Global is open to all without any restriction. So you have taken the right You have made the right decision to join this program. And I would encourage you, if you know of any other people, your friends, family members who need help to get upskilled, please tell them about this program. It's not that the company LTT Global, it's not that we are very rich. We have the funds to do this program. In fact, we were also badly hit by this pandemic. Yeah. The last 2 years has been very hard for the company. We had to struggle also, but we know we have a lot to offer, and we know there are a lot of people out there who needs to get some form of assistance, especially in upgrading their skills. So we still persisted in going through with this program to help all of you. Yeah. So through this program, perhaps all of you and even our company will prosper, and we will be able to help more people in the community, those who are really desperate for help. We want to be a part of the solution rather than the problem. Yeah. So with that, I end my sharing. Again, I welcome all of you, and I hope you all will have a successful career ahead of you, whether you decide to be employed or you decide to do a business. I wish you all the best. Yeah. So I hand it back to you, Colin.
Thank you, Chair Melis. Now, it gives me great pleasure to invite our co-founder and CEO of LTT Global, Dr. Wemmel, for his speech. Dr. Wemmel, over to you.
Okay, now.
Participant, first of all, you all are late. We are doing an internet program, which means you must respect yourself because nobody else can respect you. You can bring your food and sit right in front of your computer and do. Why I'm saying this? Very simple. Because in order to be successful, time is very important. I have the same time, you have the same time. Anyway, I'm going to tell you a story. You know, a long time ago, in a far away in a kingdom, there lived a king. And he had a favorite minister. Whatever happens, he will tell the minister. So one morning, when the king got up and he was getting himself ready to go and meet all his minister, as he was coming down, he knocked himself and broke his toe. So immediately he looked at the guard and said, "Where's the minister? Where's the minister?" So the guard, you know, went running and then brought the minister. And then the king told, "You know, minister, I was coming down to go and see all the minister. Look at my toe, it's broken." And then after the minister listening to him, he said, "All this happened for a good reason, my lord." And the king got so angry. "I'm in pain. And then you are telling me, you know, everything happened for..." And he told the king, he told the soldiers, get this minister and put him in the prison. Then the minister looked at the king and said, "All this also happened for a good reason, my lord." And the king even got more angry. He said, "Put him inside." And then he went back. And he went back and met his ministers. And he did all his thing. And that day was his hunting day. He finished his work. He went with his entire troop hunting. That particular day, he could not get any animal. Went further and further. And finally, when he looked behind, there was nobody. He was right deep inside. And suddenly, he's looking around. A few people came and caught him. And he said, "My subjects, I'm your king." They all laughed. "You see, you are my king. You're not my king. Let me take you to my king." So this was the jungle traps. They took him and then they presented to the jungle trap king. He said, "We got a subject today. And today," I said, "get him prepared. We need sacrificing." So they prepared him and everything. He said, no, "I'm the king," and everything. They never listened. They prepared him and everything. About to cut his neck, the king said, "Stop." He said, "This man is not full. His toe is broken. He cannot sacrifice." So he said, so they let the king go. The king ran, you know, coming to the palace. And then reached the palace and he said, "Where's the minister? Where's the minister?" He said, "My lord, you put him in the prison." He said, "Leave him, bring him in." And then the king told, "You know, my minister, you know what happened today morning? You know, this happened and this happened. And, you know, I was caught. And, you know, I'm about to chop. And then they let me go." And then the minister looked at it, the king, and said, "All this happened for the good, all this happened for the good lot." And then the king said, "Explain to me. Now my head is about to chop. My leg was in pain. You say all happened for a good reason. You explain to me. No, I'm going to chop your head." So the minister said, "Today morning, my lord, you came and then, you know, you broke your toe. And then I told him. And then you got angry. You put me inside the prison. And then, you know, I told him also, what do you call, all this happened for a good reason. For good, my lord. And then you left. And you see, my lord, if this didn't happen, wherever you go, I will be beside you. Today, they would have caught you, me. And if they want to sacrifice you, they would have seen your toe broken, they would have left you. And then they would have caught me for sacrificing." So you see, sir, all my lord, everything happened for a good reason. Okay. Now, the story has got this. Now, we are locked down 2 years. We are not the only people in the world that are locked down. The whole global is locked down. Now, the question we are asking ourselves, what have we learned in these 2 years? Okay? Many people have lost job. My colleagues, earlier spoke and said, you know, people have lost job. You know, the whole world has changed. It's completely changed. Now, the question is, it has given us 2 years, you know, think about, you know, what do we want to do? All right, 2 years. And people even have lost job, you know, so why this must happen to me? All that happened for a good reason. Like, you know, I told the story. Now, one way or another, this is about to happen. We are a middle-income country. We must move on to what they call a developed. If you want to get a developed status, the ministry have already found out that 86% of the Malaysian, one way or another, have to upskill. If you do not upskill, you would lose job. All right? And this is about to happen. So it is for a good reason now you are here. Now, you by upskilling, I must tell you something. The economy did shrink, but you must, like analysts said, economy will expand back again. But the question is, are you ready? When I mean by are you ready and upskill yourself? If you have upskilled yourself, I want to tell you that wherever you go, you will get job. Age is not a factor, because what we are looking is for skills. And even, you know, they said, oh, you got age, and then they take you and then they see your skill, you will thrive in any organization. All right? There's something happened that a lot of people are not aware that during these 2 years, just because we locked down, doesn't mean that the technology got locked down. The technology actually leapfrogged. So therefore, if we can embrace technology, you got a lot to gain. Wherever you go, you are going to thrive and you're going to be successful. And there are going to be a lot of jobs. You can able to pick your job, provided that you upskill yourself. Upskilling is going to be so important. And the question that you ask, you know, people while, you know, on lockdown, you know, in the next 20 years, what am I going to do? In the next 20 years, if you do not upskill, you're going to be dependent on other people. If you upskill yourself, you are on demand. That one I can tell you. You will be in demand, not just in Malaysia. You will be in demand globally. All right? Take advantage of the programs that we have designed. You are never going to get. Training is an expensive thing. And it's right in front of you, right in front of facing you. Take advantage and use all the program we have. We have millions and millions of books. You know, people say we don't have a reading culture. Because, you know, you take two, three books and put it in the counter, and it comes already $300-$400. Now everything is free for you. Choose anything and you read. You want to do research, please do research. You don't need to go and do anything. You want to do a course, any course, pick a university. Any university in the world and you can do the course. All right? You want, and there are people, you know, there are people who learn better in a video way. We have hundreds and thousands of hours of video learning. Please go and take advantage of it. I want to see success. You deserve success. Success is right in front of you, facing you. Take advantage of it. You know, it's going to be a lovely day for you. It's going to be a lovely years ahead of you. All you've got to do is upskill. Keep upskilling. You will be in demand forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Wimmer, for a very powerful message. Appreciate it.
Thank
now
you.
Now I call upon Ms. Rani Wimmer, co-founder and COO of LTT Global, to present messages from our partners. Rani, over to you.
Sure. 1 minute, please. Sorry. I'm all good now. Sorry for the little technical glitch. Here we go.
Hello, my friends. My name is Dato' Dr. Siva Anandan, and I am the honorary advisor of LTT. Totally unrecognizable. All those things that we took for granted, the normal that we believe will last forever, is now gone. And we have to find a new way to live, to coexist, to function, to be employed, and to survive. And unfortunately, many of us are not prepared for this. Many people have lost their livelihoods. Many businesses have failed, have wound up, have gone bust. And many of us are now at the crossroads of our lives. And you will feel deflated. You will feel frustrated. You will feel let down by life. And often we seek the answers for our problems outside. And we lay blame outside that I'm like this because of that event or because of this person. I think it is time for us to rethink our own existence and our own purpose for being. And so I invite you to believe in yourself and never, never give up. Now is the time to keep fighting. You know, Winston Churchill was the great Prime Minister of Great Britain during World War II, and much of the success of the Allied forces during World War II against the Nazis is attributed to Churchill. And after the war, he was invited by Harvard University to give a commencement address. And so he was introduced with great aplomb, great pedantry, fantastic testimonials, and all the participants there eagerly awaited for Churchill to share his wartime strategy with them. And when Churchill got on stage, he looked at everybody. There was thunderous applause. The applause went on for a good 5 minutes. And then finally, when the applause had settled down, Churchill looked into the audience and they were waiting for his World War II strategy. And Churchill said, "Never, never, never give up." He put his cigar in his mouth and he walked off stage. That is Winston Churchill's great Harvard address. But there is a lesson in there for all of us. And that is that life actually will throw a lot of challenges at us. But we must never, never, never give up. What you're faced with now is a new situation, a new challenge. So what you really have to do is everything that you think you've learned, some of it you have to unlearn. And then you have to relearn. So you must be prepared for new possibilities. And here at LTT Global, we welcome you to a world of new possibilities, a world of Get Employed. It's a world where you will find 5,000 online courses. You will find 100,000 of video learning. You will find 100 million ebooks, 100 million journals and articles, and many, many things that will help you re-equip yourself to face this new normal. But what you won't find in Get Employed is self-discipline, the desire to learn, the willingness to face challenges, the ability to persevere against odds. These are things only you can bring to the table. And so I invite you to bring this to the table and to start with Get Employed, with new resolve and with faith in yourself. You know, there's a story about this professor who once went and visited a Zen master. And the Zen master said to him, "Welcome, what do you want to learn?" And the professor said, "You know, I know a lot of things about Zen, but I heard you are the master. I want to learn from you." And so the professor said, "Please sit down," took a cup of tea in front of him and started pouring the tea into the cup. And of course, the professor went on to talk about his extensive knowledge, his vast knowledge of Zen. But as the professor was talking and the Zen master was pouring the tea was filled to the brim in the cup. And although it was at the brim, the Zen master kept pouring some more tea, so it began to overflow. And the professor was observing this. He couldn't take it anymore. And he said, "Excuse me, master, the cup is already full. Why are you still pouring?" And the Zen master said, "Well, you know, the cup is you. If you think that you are at the limit of your learning, then Get Employed will not help you. Any kind of learning will not help you because you are not prepared to pour out what you know and learn new things." So my wish for all of you is that you will have confidence in yourself, that you will believe that you can learn new things, and that you will participate in the program in the knowledge that you can build a better new normal for yourself, and that you can build a better world for yourself and your family. I wish you all the very best in your endeavors, and I hope that this program will help you equip yourself with enough skills and knowledge that you can now navigate, not only navigate, but thrive in the new normal. Thank you very much.
Assalamualaikum. Hi everyone, a very good afternoon to you. Hope you are doing well during the pandemic. My name, Datuk T.S. Abdul Razak Abdul Malik. I am the International President for the Chartered Institute of Logistics and Transport, CILT. Our institute was founded in 1919 with a mission to improve industry practices and nurture talent. We are 102 years now. Today, we support over 33,000 members in 37 countries in 6 continents. We are a global family representing professionals at all levels across all sectors. We have a mission to give individuals and organizations access to the tools, the knowledge, and the connection vital to success in the logistics and transport industry. I congratulate LTT Global on their GetEmployed.today nationwide impact project that reinvents learning through a structured employment readiness program, positioned to quickly get people who have lost their job on their businesses due to the pandemic and get back on their feet. To all participants, as the saying goes, a good beginning make a big difference. Make sure you begin with new energies and new hopes to experience new things and to learn things you never knew before, to make it a brighter chapter in your life as you future-proof yourself. Best wishes to you on this new beginning. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Dr. Lim Kok Yong. I'm the Dean of Faculty of Creative Multimedia in Multimedia University. Today, millions of people around the world are unemployed or underemployed, while in reality, we know many employers have jobs they cannot fill either. It is a challenge rooted in the growing mismatch between employee skills and the employer needs. Under the fourth industry revolutions, we know many industries are demanding for tech-savvy employee to increase the productivity of their business. But many employees are not equipped with the tools and the necessary knowledge to brace the change. Some do not even know a storm is coming. If you are unemployed, retrenched, or even thus feel unprepared for the technological demands of jobs today, it is time to invest to upskill yourself for the future of works so you don't stay in a vacuum, but in a coordinated, committed fashions for personal development, personal fulfillment, or even career advancement. Because technological knowledge is a universal important skill now in the modern workforce. In today's fast-paced knowledge economy and ever-evolving working conditions, it is you who can decide your accomplishment. Sign up today for the free programs in Get Employed Today, for their online courses and wonderful tech-related resources, all pivoted to different industries in the digital economy, to prep yourself for the jobs of tomorrow. I believe this is an ecosystem that we need to build together to align across educations as well as industry, aiming to improve the potential employment outcomes for the nations. These programs, I believe, will improve your tech knowledge, your skills, as well as your competency, regardless of your formal educations. Now everyone can have the opportunity to learn tech skills. Do not be beaten by any setbacks. Let's help you to get back on track.
Good day. I am Dr. Shekhar Jagannathan. I'm the advisor to H2L, which is a community partner of Get Employed Today. Now, I'm also the Director of Digital Strategy in a leading investment bank in Malaysia. Throughout the whole 2 years, I've seen a lot of people were struggling in staying their job and are struggling to reskill themselves for a better opportunity. At the same time, I've seen a lot of organizations struggling to become digitally enabled. GetEmployed Today creates the right platform for people who want to be reskilled and future-proof their jobs, as well as corporates to participate in this program, which is timely and appropriate, and get the right skilled employees or staff and resources to start their digital transformation journey and embrace themselves for the future change that is to happen. I wish all of you all good luck and hope you all will find a beautiful collaboration together with GetEmployed Today, corporates and people alike. Thank you very much.
Hi everyone, I'm Shak Munisami, one of the co-founders of Parti Komedi Rakyat. We're very happy to be one of the community partners in support of GetEmployed.today, a training and development venture to get Malaysians back on their feet after almost a two-year battle with a worldwide pandemic. I'd like to wish all the best to the first cohort of GetEmployed.today. Make full use of the opportunities that lie ahead and make us proud. Thank you to all the donors and sponsors who have helped make this dream a reality. Here's to many more adventures ahead. Remember, you can still contribute to GetEmployed.today through funds, likes and shares and comments. Thank you very much and have a nice day.
Hi everyone, I'm James from Parti Komedi Rakyat, a community partner with GetEmployed.today. So we'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate the team behind GetEmployed.today on your very first cohort and hopefully the first of many more to come. And to the first cohort, welcome on board to this wonderful journey. And for most of you, it is the first step to a lot of things. For some, it's the first step towards a new beginning. For some, it is the first step towards the road to recovery. So with that, I hope that you will actually gain as much knowledge and skills throughout your journey here with GetEmployed.today. So with that, all the very best of success and see you at the top. Take care.
Hi there, my name is Faisal American and I'd like to congratulate the first cohort at GetEmployed.today. Now you're taking the first step towards a better and brighter future. You are all magnificent, glorious individuals and I wish you all the best.
Hey everyone, I'm Juliana Heng from Parti Komedi Rakyat, also known as PKR. We are blessed to be the community partner of GetEmployed.today. Together, we hope to get fellow Malaysians and the local economy back on its feet. To our very first cohort of GetEmployed.today, well done on taking the first step to get yourself ready for the job market. You are integral to the recovery of the Malaysian economy. Make the best of this opportunity to learn as much as you can, make as many meaningful connections possible, and most importantly, have fun. Thank you so much. I wish you all great success with GetEmployed.today. Together, let's bring Malaysia to greater heights. Majulah diri untuk negara.
Hi, I'm Wendy from Parti Komedi Rakyat, one of the community partners of GetEmployed.today. Congratulations to the first cohort of GetEmployed.today. Every success starts with first step. You're almost there. Kudos for being proactive to take up the first golden step to sharpen the saw, just like the Stephen Covey say. Thanks for the donors and supporters for making the event success. Congratulations to all again.
Hi, I'm Huraira from Study Germany and I support GetEmployed.today because I truly believe the program can help all of you out there who are currently out of a job to reskill and upskill or even start your own business and make your own income. The program is very flexible to suit your busy schedule and it's packed with courses that teaches you current and in-demand skills so you can be sure that this course will help you further. Last but not least, I wish all the participants all the best. May you get all the relevant skills that you need, and may you go out there and get your new job.
Hi, I'm Charles from Digital Marketing Consultancy, DMC, a training company specializing in helping businesses increase their sales and profit by equipping them with digital marketing knowledge. GetEmployed Today is a fantastic initiative to help individuals who lost their job or retrenched to upskill themselves. DMC supports these initiatives because times are tough, and we want to do our best to help in any way we can. We believe in GetEmployed values and, of course, the leadership which will make these initiatives a reality. I want to remind all participants not to give up. And remember, tough times don't last, but tough people do. And one of the best ways to quickly get out from all this challenging time will be by upskilling ourselves with relevant skill sets today. Like learning any new skills, it won't be easy to focus in the beginning, but you know, if you stay consistent, I'm sure that you will succeed. All the best from me, Charles Gregory, DMC. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. My name is Justin J. Anthony, Executive Director at PCOM, the National Tech Association of Malaysia. LTT Global is currently running this Get Employed initiative, and PCOM is in support of this initiative, which addresses the grave challenges Malaysians are facing in light of this ongoing pandemic, which has been haunting us for the last 2 years, almost for the 2 years. And many of us, many of our friends have lost their jobs and seeking employment. The program that LTT Global is running will help you seek employment through the kind of programs that they are conducting, and which will be, of course, very helpful to you. Now, I will encourage each and every one of you to actively participate in this program, and keep your spirits high, stay focused, and be excited, because there might be something in store for you in the near future. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I wish you all the very best, and take care, stay safe, and stay excited all the time. Thank you.
Today we have with us Mr. Eric Chan, who is representing our community partner, H2L, and he's sharing on wellness. How are you today, Eric?
Hi, good morning, everyone. So how are you today? You know, sometimes these terms, right, we take it quite lightly. We just, hey, how are you today? But, you know, we don't really care, right? But, you know, it's important to ask ourselves, how are you today, right now? Yeah? Okay, thanks. So my name is Eric. I'm representing Happiness to Life. Okay, earlier you saw a video by our founder, Dr. Shekhar. Okay, so we are part of this group. We are a group of volunteers, right? So we got started. We are involved in conducting wellness retreats, meditation sessions, and now we're doing counseling work as well. Okay, so we are looking to, you know, create a better, happier world, you know, for each and every one of you, right? And for, yeah, for the world. Okay, so again, how are you today? Like today, I like what we spoke about today. You know, it's not the end of the world, right? This pandemic, 2020, it's not the end of the world. And another thing I liked today was never give up, right? We talk about Winston Churchill's speech. And lastly, and more importantly, right, keep this in mind. Be on time, be early. Okay? Now, my company was somewhere in the logos earlier. If I have an interview with you and you come late, right? Sorry, 1 minute late is late. It doesn't matter. Yeah? So just keep track of that for participants, for those. Right? There was somebody who came in 27 minutes late. You might as well just turn back if you're meeting me. Yeah? Okay, that is for sure. Turn back. Don't bother. Yeah? Don't bother to come. All right. Okay, now, back to happier things. But this is reality, you know. It's easy to succeed. But whether we take the steps, whether we respect ourselves enough and respect the other enough to do the necessary. Yeah? Okay, good. Back to happiness to life. Okay, now we get back to the relaxing topic, right? So what we are involved in, you know, promoting mindfulness about being in the present. Yeah, very often, you know, when we let's talk about everything that's affecting us right now, pandemic, MCO, salaries cut, job losses, right? Okay, is there anyone here who might want to share, participants, right? What you're experiencing right now, if you're having any experiences. Anyone? Anyone? No? Right. So, okay, now, let us share what, I will share with you what we've seen in recent times, because we started the counseling and care initiative when, you know, at that time there was that white flag suddenly people are like one of those MCOs, then people are starving. Okay, so we started our helpline then. It's heartbreaking, okay, no matter whatever you're facing now, no job but you know, you still got money to get online, you still have a phone for now to log in, right? You know, we had someone, a woman, right, who called in. She had diabetes and she was amputated and jobless. She was depressed, right? So she joined our sessions. We had one of our counselors call and follow up. And, you know, she got, she felt better after that, yeah? There was also someone I dealt with directly. Is a foreigner, you know. MCO come in, you got no jobs. If you're daily paid, you're a construction worker, right? You got no jobs, zero. So he was saying he wants to send money back home. No job, no money, and he wanted to jump off the building. Okay, he wanted to jump off his apartment block. So I said, hey, no, come on. But so eventually, after, you know, I talked to him, sense got in him, because what's important is, you know, and there's a lot of families, no food to feed the families. So at that time, we did Happiness to Life, we did have a care package, a basic foodstuffs. We did those things, right? But I think, so our counseling, it did help with some of the those who are down and out. We have our helpline, yeah? Rani or administrator, do you mind putting up our, yes. So if you can see here, if at all you need someone to just talk to, right? No matter how insignificant, right? Just contact that number. We have a group of counselors who will listen to you. Yeah. All right. You know the problem. One thing that when we speak to those people who called up, right? Sometimes it's about our urban lifestyle, our urban setting right here. You know, we come to KL, want to cari makan, want to find a job. Then we are away from our family unit. or even our families could be suffering as well, right? We are outstationed. They are, you know, back in the hometown. So we don't have the family unit. We lose that support group, you know, and this creates, you know, you might have a feeling of loneliness. You are alienated. Yeah. You don't feel in control with yourself, with the things happen to you, right? You feel helpless. Suddenly your company says, we have to let you go, lah. Right? We have no income. We have to let you go. We are closing down. What can you do? Right? You can't do much. Right? You can't do anything about it. But what you can do is how you look at this. Like earlier we said, right? We looked at it. Never give up. Right? Never give up. That was a very good statement. Like for myself also, right? So when MCO came along, I looked at my business partner, who's my wife, all right? And I was like, God, what's going to happen? Oh my God, right? But that feeling lasted like half a day, all right? Then we just got up and just, okay, let's carry on as usual. As usual. And fair enough, because of how we perceive things, right? We perceive it, we sourced it, and things just carried on as normal. So there was really nothing to worry about, okay? Don't forget, our mind, right? It's very naughty. It plays tricks on us. It tells us, oh my God, things are going to be bad, right? But hey, each one of every one of you, right, participants, you're here, you're still alive, you're still breathing, right? Correct, na? Yes. Okay, so back to if at any point you need to talk, all right, you need someone to talk to. The number is there, the 018 number. Is the image still up there? I can't see, all right? So if anything at all, you can contact LTT Global, you can contact, Get Employed Today, or you just... Okay, the image is not, I can't see the image. So you can just get in touch, okay? Miss Rani, can you put the second picture, the app? Now, how we can help you is, first is, of course, you can call us. Yeah, thanks. You can call us, that number, the 018 number earlier, okay, if you need someone to talk to. Secondly, we conduct classes, meditation classes, all right, daily, every single day. So if you can, contact me directly with regards to this also. Okay, I'm sure I have no issues with LTT Global, Get Employed Today, sharing my phone number. Yeah, just share my number. We conduct meditation classes every day. Okay, and we have this app. So our commitment to global wellness, right? We created this app, Happiness to Life, H2L app. You can get it for your Android. You can get it for your Apple as well. You download it. And there is guided meditation, there's music. You know, so you can just relax and just put your mind at ease. Yeah? Okay, so you can search for it, Happiness to Life. All right, so... So just don't, you know, in conclusion, right, don't worry too much. Yeah. And if you are really stressed, you have no one to talk to, call this number. Okay. Our team will lend you our ears and we will assist you and see how to get back on your feet, to get your stresses, your worries, you know. And normally it's just to clear that mind that is telling you all these negative things, right? Okay, so thank you very much. That's it from me for today. If you'd like to find out anything else, just get in touch with us directly, yeah? All right, thank you very much for your time. And thank you very much for LTT Global and Get Employed Today for having us. Thank you.
Thank you, Eric, for your sharing from H2L. How are you today? Now, I would like to invite again Ms. Rani Wimmer again to share about Get Employed Today's Employment Readiness Program. Rani, over to you. need to unmute, Rani, and share.
Yeah, thank you, Colin. Let me just share my screen. Can y'all see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, great. So, good afternoon. No, good morning again to everybody. I hope you are having a inspiring moment here at the cohort's launch today. Just to brief everybody about again what GetEmployed.today is about. Start again. Okay, I'm all good now. 1 minute. Can see my screen now?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Thank you for your patience. Now, just to quickly tell you what GetEmployed.today is all about, I will tell you the reason that we actually started this is because we wanted to actually help out and create a skill of talented pool, a skilled talent pool for the people, and also offer solution for the unemployment to close their skill gap, right? So we are inviting government and ministries and agencies to come on board to actually support this initiative in any way that they can, so that together we become a catalyst to reset and rebuild our Malaysian economy. So we actually welcome people who have lost their jobs, who have lost their businesses, unemployed graduates, and also underemployed Malaysians to help them to actually move forward in their lives. Currently, according to the Department of Statistics in Malaysia, 89% of Malaysians, this includes both employed and unemployed Malaysians, lack the skills that they need to meet the demands of employers or businesses. Work has changed, right? So we have to actually pick up like skill sets, both digital and soft skills. Now, our platform and our program is 100% online, making it easy for you, giving you maximum flexibility. You learn at your own time, right? And we also cater for different learning needs, because some people like to do courses, some like to read, some like to view videos and they learn faster. But at the end of the day, if you can produce a certificate for whatever that you claim that you know, it actually value adds to your knowledge, right? So what we encourage our participants to do is actually do the courses so that they can have evidence to show that the university has sent them an email to say that they have completed the courses. But to enhance their knowledge further, they can go and view videos if they are a person that, you know, learns better through videos, and also read books, because in this way, they have both all the senses in play, from reading to hearing. And so the brain captures and, you know, it makes you even pick up things faster. So our program is structured because we actually read a report with the International Labour Organization, which stated that people right now, they need to be actually inspired, motivated, pick up skills, but not only digital skills, but soft skills as well. That's why we have given our platform to the participant for 12 months, because although the compulsory 6 weeks is where they are supposed to pick up skill sets and get certificate before they choose their pathway, but the reason the 12 months access is to give them lifelong learning opportunities. So we have our platform, And we also empower unemployed graduates and people who are retrenched and professionals. So these are the mandatory courses where they have an option to choose either one, and they also have to complete one compulsory course. So once they have completed this is when they actually are ready to actually embark on their journey. Also, we give them mastery classes. What are mastery classes? Mastery classes are run by experts or our partners and sponsors. We'll give a skill that they can monetize, right? So if they're doing freelance, immediately they can use the skill to monetize. If they're working in an organization, this will make them a more valuable employee. And an example is like this afternoon, our mastery class is by Multimedia University on video production skills. So it's a two-day program, today and tomorrow. And all our participants will actually benefit from this because they also get a certificate from MMU. At the same time, they would have had a skill that now they can monetize as well. And besides mastery classes, we also have knowledge sharing webinars where we invite experts, CEOs, successful people to share, to inspire, also share with you what's happening in the corporate world, get you tips, techniques, skills, right, that you need to survive in corporate world. And this is what the purpose of the knowledge sharing webinars is. And of course, we have forums to in our learning platform to encourage collaborative learning, so that in case any participants didn't understand anything, they can put it in the forum. At the same time, everybody shares. But this is also to build bonding, social skills, and also to improve communication in form of writing. That's the purpose of the forum. Okay. And so, as I said, after the 6 weeks, they are ready. Their self-confidence, their self-esteem, their social skill, communication skills, and everything is in place. They choose their pathway. They can either opt to get a job, do freelance, or start something on their own, right? So if they want to get a job, we actually provide them further skill sets like in resumes and interview skills, and at the same time, link them to our hiring partners. If they want to do freelance, we link them to platforms that actually offer freelance jobs. And if they want to do a startup, then Magic is one of our partners as well. And they will actually guide the person from a startup as to the steps taken and offer them programs that is suitable for an entrepreneur. So our platform is given for 12 months. Reason being, they may have got a job, and at the job, maybe they needed to upskill further. Maybe they needed project management or Excel or something to do with big data, right? They don't have to worry, I need money or I don't have time, because now they have something with them and they can learn on the job, like what they say, just on time learning, okay? So basically, this is what we have, and we continue to monitor them and help them the next 12 months because we want to see them successful. Their success is our success. So we will actually monitor career growth and business growth. And together, we hope to actually see all of you be successful. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Rani. Now it's time to meet our Get Employed Today's Cohort 1 participants. I'd like all the participants to switch on their cameras so that we can have a look at you. And as I call your name one by one, we wish that you'll be able to give at least a 1 minute insight about yourself and what you hope to achieve by participating at Get Employed Today. Can I have the participants to switch on their cameras? Thank you. Can you switch on your mic, please, as I call everyone? Okay, Faye, can you start? Faye?
All right. Okay, hello, good morning, everyone. Nice to meet you all today. Yeah, I'm the participant in the cohort one. So actually, I'm now, I resigned since November 2020. Then after that, I started like doing some freelance job. and is doing as a virtual assistant. So now off and on, I have a virtual assistant with a hardware solution. So she is the agency founder for the hardware solution. So I'm working as a freelance with her. Then so off and on, I get some freelance job, something like help others, like sourcing, logistic, also booking for logistic, and then some admin tasks, payroll tasks. So actually I work as a sales administrator for past 10 years. So like some payroll, actually I'm not really familiar with, but she taught, she teach me how to do it. So actually it's like virtual assistant, some sort like going to be like multitasking. So a lot of things have to be upskilled. That's why I joined this Get Employed Today. And I've logged into the platform and I found that it's really interesting and a lot of things to learn. So actually, and I realized that the more I learn, the more I realize I don't know so many things. So they're really, really, learning is actually not boring. It's up to you all, see how you're going to it's your mindset. So I'm really happy that I know Get Employed Today. And happy to see you all. Thank you. That's my sharing. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Shafinas, did you see something?
Hey. Hey. Hello, everyone.
Hey.
Hello.
Okay, actually, previously I was working as an account executive. Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Loud and clear.
Okay, then after that, because of the pandemic COVID-19, then the company that I work is retrenched people, and I was affected from that. So after that, I was doing, then I have applied so many jobs, but it's very difficult to get. Then my friend asked me to just doing some online networking business. Then by doing that, I feel that I need so many skills that like such digital marketing, so this course will help me to develop the skills, especially on the digital part. That's all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Miss Liu, you're ready?
Oh, hi. Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, I'm clear.
Yeah, okay. Sorry, I joined a little bit late. Okay, basically, my objective of this session is that I like to learn more because I think although that I've been with the organization...
Can you highlight her? Okay, thanks.
For 38 years, and I actually left the organization last year because they did some restructuring. But life is always learning, even though age is not a number. Age is just a number. So that's one of my objectives, is to learn more and know more people, and also to do networking lah. And also maybe from here I can find something that I think I would like to do, which I never had the opportunity to do while I was really in a corporate world for the 38 years. So this is my objective. So just hello to everyone of you. And I've got my friend with me also, I think, in this session, Huichin, who has actually recommended me to join this as well. So thanks, Huichin. It's a very interesting session, and I can see the platform. There's so many things that you can do that will keep you occupied. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah. Huichin, would you like to continue from there?
Hi everyone. I'm Huichin. I was in the banking industry for 17 years, so Sawa's junior, so called. So we left the bank together last year when our department was outsourced lah, basically. So I actually learned of Get Employed through DMC, where I took a digital marketing course previously. So after joining GetEmployed, I mean from the platform, I can see actually there are a lot of different courses, not only related to digital marketing, but also languages. I think even that day, Miss Rani also shared about the games where you can learn and play games at the same time. Yeah, so I think that that is a very good... I think similar to everyone, we all need to keep upskilling ourselves, you know, learn more things that can enrich our, you know, either enrich our future career or even our experience so that we can perform better in the future. So I think at the end of this, I suppose my goal or my target is to see if I can learn something, and then at the end of the day, you know, be able to do some freelance job or even start my own business. I actually already have some e-commerce store on Shopee and Lazada, Sawa as well. Yeah, so we all joined similar programs together so that at least we have a friend that, you know, can motivate each other to do better. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's all for my sharing. Thank you.
Thank you. Jody, would you like to continue from there, Jody?
Hi, good morning, everyone.
Morning.
My name is Jody, and I was a quantity surveyor for around 30 years. I'm just recently get retrenched, and currently I'm working as a freelance quantity surveyor. First of all, thanks for having me, and I'm proud to be one of the Get Employed Today cohort. This is a very good program which I can get myself ready on the next step of either business or employment. I do hope that at the end of this program, I'm able to upskill myself in other field outside of the field that I have been with all this while. Once again, thanks for this opportunity, and let's learn together. Thanks.
Thanks, Judy. Who else do we have? Rolly, are you online, Rolly?
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Yeah, I'm sorry. Actually, very insecure with everybody who's speaking right now because they're very influenced in.
No worries.
I'm actually very nervous right now. Okay, what I've said is that during 2020, life is very hard for me. I was working as a retail sales assistant, and then due to the pandemic, I had to let go. And then I need to find something. So I went to I move out from the place where I live and work on, and then do part-time in Subway, and then I apply for a few jobs. And recently, just this early months, I recruited as a admin program coordinator. And then I looking, I know this program, been introduced by, for me by my mentor, which is Puan Fatima Bubaka. I think Dr. Wani Rahman might know her.
Yes, she's my good friend.
Yeah, so he introduced this program to me. The reason why I joined this program is because if I can, I wonder to myself that if I can go, if I can achieve something that is which very rare for me, it happened to me very rare. I might wonder to myself what is might happen to me in the future if I push myself for my limits
to improve yourself further.
So I also forget to mention that I'm also a postgraduate student. I'm a final year student. And then one of my research is to understand the potential and challenges of the filmmaking industry in Sabah. I am a Sabahan. So I wonder if that the film industry in Sabah is actually very very small and underdeveloped, and I tend to create my production film in Sabah and to create content that showcase the cultures and the community that is really showcased in the local film. So I joined this program to understand more about the business, something like that lah. Thank you.
Thank you, Ronnie. Thank you.
Thank you all.
I think we have all the participants who have given their speech, Rani. Would you like to play Miss Mangalika's video recording, Rani?
Yes, sir. 1 minute, please.
Thank you.
While Rani is preparing, I just want to ask a question. Are all of you, the participants, based here in Selangor or Kuala Lumpur, or you are all over the place, all over Malaysia?
I am Faye. I'm from Selangor.
Okay.
I'm Shafinas from Penang.
From Penang, okay. Rolly.
Jody here from KL.
Oh, KL, okay.
I'm from Sabah, but currently staying in Shah Alam, Selangor.
In Shah Alam, okay. Right. I thought Rolly was in Sabah, so we have a good mix of people from all over the country.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Annalise. Rani, over to you.
Okay, thank you. So this is one of our participants who couldn't attend today, but she sent a video. Can you all see my screen?
Yes.
Yeah.
Good morning, all. My name is Mangalika. I'm sorry I'm not able to join the sessions today. Just to give you a brief intro, I was an accountant, or I am a certified public accountant, and I retired in 2010. I have been doing various projects, which included helping friends with computerizing their account systems. And for the past 5 years, I've been a public mutual agent. I basically worked in two industries. For the first 10 years of my working life, I was an auditor with Coopers and with Kasim Chan. And for the balance of the time, I was in hotels. I think I worked in about 7 or 8 hotels. About 4 of them were out of Malaysia, but within Asia. And the last hotel was in Kota Kinabalu. And I'm basically looking at renewing my skills and going further into my freelance work. Yeah, but with updated knowledge. Thank you, Rani, for giving me the opportunity to join this cohort. Yeah, I probably will see all of you on Saturday with the MMU presentation. Yeah. Enjoy your day today. Yeah, until I see you on Saturday.
That's it, Colin.
Thank you, Rani.
Interesting.
We got a good mix, right?
Yeah.
Can all of you please switch on your camera again. Let's give a big clap to our participants who actually participated in this forum.
Best of luck, everyone.
Yeah.
All the best to everyone.
All right. Let me take a group photo. Hold on a minute. Okay, all smile.
Give your best smile.
Say cheese. Okay, thank you.
Thank
you. Let me save the file first. The before it disappears. Okay, it's done. All right, we have actually come to the end of the today's program. Friendly reminder, we have a 2 p.m. They call it a photography masterclass session with MMU. And we at LTT Global would like to wish everyone, especially the participants, the best of luck and, you know, carry on. We know you can do it. Thank you. Rani, Dr. Wemel, do you have anything to say? Final words?
Yeah. You know, the program that MMU is going to run, if you go on your own, it's an expensive program, you know, no? And particularly people at this age group, you know, no? It's spectacular. You should take every opportunity and to participate and understand. If you don't understand, don't worry. Don't worry, okay? okay, like Fonson, if you think that you need a help from what you call, let's say a 7 or 8 years old child who's, you know, very good with the device, don't be shy. Treat the child as a teacher. All right? Sit with the child and tell that the child must feel that the next time I want to teach you. All right? That is learning. If you respect the person who's going to teach you, your learning becomes, the journey becomes very, very happy journey. All right? So today's, you know, the video section they're going to teach you, it's actually, they are combined the whole thing in one pack. And, you know, no, so you're learning, and then you can actually repeat that again and again. And if you do not understand there, go further into our program, and you can get many more support programs. Right? So therefore, please take advantage. Age is not a factor here. All right? All of you must ask yourself, I ask myself, okay, how long am I going to live another? Oh, another 20 years. Am I going to get supported by the young people to help me with the device and all that? No, no, no. I'm going to be on my own. So I said, I got to learn technology because technology is going to be part of our life. If you agree and if you because technology is already part of our life. The more you may able to embrace, your life will become better. Wherever you go, because every part of the world, if you go to China, you know, transaction of money, you know, they don't want to take cash from you. All right? And so it's going to happen in all parts of the world. So please enjoy. Come at today, what do you call, and see and learn. That's what I want to tell you. Enjoy it. Age is not a factor. Age is just purely a number.
Yes, yes. It's a number.
Right, thank you.
Yeah, and always, always 28.
Very good. I love that. I love that.
28. Yes, yes.
But not 21 now.
No, 28 got more busy than 21 la.
Yeah, I want to add something.
Chinese good number la.
Okay.
Okay, can I just add something? A lot of you have expressed admiration or you're quite impressed with the contents that we have in our platform, and you think it is going to be very helpful. So please help to spread the word. If you have relatives, family members, friends, ex-colleagues, office colleagues, if you know that they need help, please tell them about this program. We want to be able to help more and more people. Regardless of age, whether you are 28 or 28, we still can help you to at least upskill and let you learn something new. Yeah. So please spread the word. Please tell them about this program. Please invite them to this program. And if you want, we can talk to them personally and issue invitations for them to join us. Yeah. So again, yeah. I thank everyone. Yeah. Thank you.
After this session, every one of you bring one friend.
Yeah, that should be the way.
Bring one not enough. You want to reach out to some 1,000 people. So one person not enough. Each person bring 5-10 people.
Yesterday I learned from Rani. One step at a time.
Okay, every day one person. Okay, fair. Every day one person. One step at a time.
Okay, bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Have you all registered for the course, for the video? If you haven't, the registration is actually closed, but you can send a message to Colin and we'll send you the link to come in at 2 o'clock. All right?
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.
Bye.
Happy weekend.